Oh no, guys, what did I do? I made a grave mistake. I made a massive mistake. Has it happened to you? Well, what I'm talking about is I actually invested in Steinhoff. Yes, I did. I'm guilty as charged. So, yeah, let's just get it out of the way and let me just talk about Steinhoff. In this episode, I'm going to start a new series. We're going to talk about shares. I'm just going to take random shares that I'm looking at the moment or I want to get off my chest. Something that I think everybody can look at and hopefully you learn something. So yeah, Steinhoff guys. It was run by this guy, Mr. Markus Jooste. A very interesting guy. He made a lot of money, but he also spent a lot of money. He had a love for breeding horses and all of these fancy things. And he was the guy that started, was one of the first guys that was in the Steinhoff business. And he's a CA. South Africa, like you know, South Africa likes their CAs. If you're a chartered accountant, then definitely you'll get a job as either the CEO or a company or the CFO. Doesn't matter what type of company, if you know the business or not, if you're a CA, then you're gonna get the job. So he got the job. He's quite intelligent, I must say, because if you look what he did over the years with Steinhoff and the scandal that broke out, they were cooking the books not for 2-3 years, they were cooking the books for the last 10 or 15 years. A lot of people lost a lot of money, and it's not nice to lose that amount of money, but that's how you learn, eh? So, yeah, this guy, he'll probably not go to jail because he's smart enough to have covered his tracks. Anyway, so what does Steinhoff do? Except if you look at their business model, it's probably, you can say now it's to lose a lot of money, but they probably made a lot of people a lot of money in the early days, and him himself got rich. If you look at his net worth, I mean Markus Jooste's net worth, is reportedly 400 million USD. So that's a lot for a guy from South Africa. But if you look at their brands, they've got a lot of things. I mean, a lot of it's in South Africa, but it's a lot of it's in Europe. Different things, but household goods, general merchandise. I mean, it's brands you know. I see they're getting rid of the automotive section in the presentation we're going to go through. But there's a lot of good brands still here that has some value. For a company that's this old, I don't know how they did it. They hoodwinked everybody. If somebody tells you, listen here, I knew Steinhoff was going down, tell them you are a liar. Nobody knew. There was a few people that were like whistleblowers, but everybody still invested their money. Everybody thought it's going through a tough time. Nobody knew beforehand. So I think I bought my shares like 2-3 months before it went down. And unfortunately, I went through all the books or all the financial statements and the booklets that they give the investors. I went through all those things. You can go scrutinize them. There's no problem there. It looks completely correct. So that's the problem. It gets hidden that well that you won't ever see it. I mean, there's no, everything was just, they inflated earnings, they inflated equity, they, to get to get more a bigger lending, or to get obviously more loans, to get the bigger debt facility. So they did all of this, But yeah, nobody. No, we I'm still. I don't know how it works, how you can do this for years and years and get away with it. But yeah, they did it. So if you go look at this, is now the newest or the most consolidated. It's like an investor presentation, and it came out, yeah, just like 2 3 weeks back. So it's the newest one to date. So just a quick thing I want to say here, or that I want to highlight, that shows you how bad it is at the moment. Would I buy a stock now? No. You'll have to wait for it for a year to get good results. Then maybe you can think of maybe. And just remember, I'm not a financial advisor. But don't go near the scene at the moment. So their total debt is 9.09 billion euros. That's a lot. It's a lot of money that they owe the banks. But you'll see now, they had restatements, and they only did like proper restatements for the last 2 or 3 years because they just had a cutoff point. They couldn't. So, as this reported 30 September 2016, they had 16 billion euros of equity. It's been restated to 2.6, 2.1, sorry, billion. So remember, the debt is 9.09, on what did we say now? So, but they're basically, they're insolvent. They by far insolvent. They don't have money. They're insolvent. There's no other way to say it. You'll get nothing back. They owe the creditors so much money. They don't have. They've already tried to sell a lot of their investments and stuff. They don't have anything to sell anymore. So they are screwed. If you go look at the next year, I think if you go look here at 2018. Let's go look at 2018 quickly. Are they refinancing? Their equity is even less. 1.8 billion. So, yeah, it's not looking good. So, I also lost a lot of money in Steinhoff. I mean, people are gonna tell you no, I saw it coming and whatever, but no. Because if you go this far to hide all of these things in the books and it's been done over years and years, how would you as an investor know this? I mean, except if you were a CA or an accountant and you go look at and you go scrutinize their books and go scrutinize every deal they've made and go look at these things, how would you know? Because if you take the audited results, I mean, you must have trust in the auditor. And clearly, nobody trusted these auditors. So, how can the auditor sign off every year? I mean, they are the smart people in the room. Shouldn't they be able to see this? But then again, Markus Jooste and the other guy, Ben Legrand, he was also a CA. So, they cooked the books together, man. Or maybe they didn't. But I would say it's a good assumption to make if they had some sort of knowing. Because if you have a business, how don't you know what's going on there? I mean, it's your business. You have been there for 20 odd years. And you're telling me you don't know what's going on in your own business. I find it very hard to believe. But yeah, some people play ignorant, eh? So, and what do? They get rich. They've got hundreds of millions of dollars, and we put our money into Steinhoff, and we lose at the end of the day. I mean, let's go look what the share did. So, it lost about 98% of its value. So, if you had 100 rand invested in Steinhoff, you would have now 1 rand and 17 cents. So you wouldn't have any money left. And yeah, some people just play dumb and they just get away with it. So, but looking for red flags, you could have probably put in Steinhoff on the internet and Googled it and saw somebody somewhere posted something that they are busy with a Ponzi scheme or whatever. But if you are an investor and you actually took the time to go through their financials, you would have seen that everything sort of makes sense. I mean, you had to go like back 5-6 years and do like a forensic, because everything looked right. I mean, and what do you go on? You go on the current valuation of the stock or the share, and you see what it's trading for, and you look at the market and everything, and you just don't look at one thing on the income statement. I mean, how much debt they have. And they had more than enough equity if they got in trouble to sell that equity and cover the debt. Now it's like they've got a fifth of the equity to cover the debt. So they, I mean, a company can't get in this debt amount. They can't even qualify for this debt. If they just came up normal and made debt all the years, they wouldn't, it's impossible to qualify for that much debt. I mean, 5 times your equity. So no bank would be stupid enough to give you that kind of equity. So yeah, guys, this is my take on Steinhoff. There's probably a lot that you can say, that we all can say, but I made a mistake. I invested in them. I lost the money. So, but you have to take these type of moments as learning experiences. So, yeah, guys, tell me what you think. Did you lose money in Steinhoff, or what happened? Okay, hope you have a great day.